I'm Alejandro Flores, and I'm an associate professor in the geosciences department at Boise State University.
And I'm Nancy Glenn. I'm a professor in the department of geosciences at Boise State University.
Basically, what we're working on is putting together a bunch of data sets that will support the decision making of wine growers and potential wine growers throughout this Snake River American viticultural area. So, to provide them information in helping select varietals that might be best suited to the climate, soils, and topography of this area.
What Alejo just described is something that we're putting together across a large-scale area, a large geographic area. But we're also interested in really fine-scale information so that we can tell information about the landscape at individual row, for example, about how the soils are, what the soils are, what the texture is, and how air flows across the slope. And so what we're going to do at a fine scale is use something called terrestrial laser scanning, remote sensing, which is a laser-based system that will provide a 3D image of the Earth's surface and particularly of different vineyards.
We do a lot of modeling in my group. You know, we use very sophisticated weather and climate models, and the hope is to be able to take these complex data sets and distill information that is actionable for growers and potential growers to be able to make decisions about wine growing that are to the benefit of their wine growing operations. And one of the interesting things about this as well is that wine, grapes, and stone fruits in particular require very long lead times for capital investment, and so wine growers are known to care about very long time horizons in terms of getting information about things like weather and climate and geography.
This is a unique opportunity for Boise State to work with local growers and to take the technology from the university out into the field, and so this is an opportunity for it's a kind of a win-win situation where we get to showcase what our students are capable of doing and how that might be useful to the greater community. And it's an opportunity for growers to get to learn new information about the landscape and start to ask questions that they might not have been able to ask before.